organization, agendas, and policies to be coordinated in order to achieve coherent policies. Why multilateral governance is really important when we talk about the climate change? Because climate change, as you might already aware, is not the responsibility of one agency alone, for example, environmental agency. This is also the responsibility of other related agencies such as transport agency, mineral resource agency, energy agency, and so on. And this is not only at the hand of the national government, but also at the hand of the local and provincial governments to contribute and to work together to achieve and to address the challenge of climate change. So, advancing multilateral governance approach, which emphasizes the coordination among all level of government and relevant stakeholders, is crucial to avoid policy gaps, uncoordinated actions, and miscommunication to effectively and efficiently implement local action plans and national policy frameworks. There are two dimensions of multilateral governance approach. The first dimension is vertical dimension, which explore the linkages between higher and lower level of government, including their institutional, financial, and informational aspect. While the dimension of horizontal covers the cooperation arrangement between regions or between municipalities. So, Indonesia has committed to reduce emissions by 29% from business as usual or BAU and 41% with international support in 2030. So the issue that we want to tackle is how to ensure a sound process from the national target or vision to implementation at the local level. As you can see in front of you, there are three kinds of government in Indonesia. The first one is national government. We have ministries led by president. And we have 34 provincial governments as regional government or subnational government. One of the province is our capital city itself, DKI Jakarta. And below provincial government, we have local governments consists of 93 cities and 416 regencies. Cities and regencies are actually at the same level. The main difference between them is that in the cities, the main activities or economic activities are industry and services, while at the regencies, the main economic activities are agriculture and natural resource management. So the focus on urban led to project is how we can enhance the vertical integration related to low emission urban development strategies in Indonesia. There are three steps that we did in order to enhance the vertical integration in Indonesia. The first one is we do literature review by scoping assessment of national climate plans, policies and regulation, review local climate action plans, and review academic literature on climate and cities. This is where we can get the idea what are the institutional arrangement is in Indonesia in terms of climate change. Then we went through in-depth interview with Secretariat in the Ministry of National Development Planning, Director of JG Inventory and MRT at the Ministry of Environment and Forestry. We also had a discussion with Coordination Ministry for Economic Affairs, Presidential Special Envoy for Climate Change, and the Center of Climate Change and Multilateral Financing Policies under the Ministry of Finance. Then we also conduct several workshops or dialogue. The first one is the city-to-city dialogue, which is a forum for cities to discuss progress, challenges, and needs of local governments in supporting NDC. It can be in the form of capacity building, technical assistance, and so on. And the second one is Regency City to Province Dialogue, which was held in Kalimantan October 2018, and then City to Province Dialogue in Java Cluster, which is held in November 2018. This is also a venue for the city and the and provinces to discuss the progress, challenges, and identify opportunities in improving collaboration between city and province in achieving the NDC. And the result of all discussions, we will present it to the national government in the Talanoa Dialogue Forum to be held next year as a multi-stakeholder dialogue introduced in COP23 as a multi-stakeholder dialogue that focus on facilitating collaborations instead of blaming one another. And in the following slides, I'll be presenting our findings on the national policies and implementation that capture multi-level governance approach on climate change in Indonesia. The first one is the national GHG inventory system. Indonesia has developed this national GHG inventory system called SciSmart, which is a simplification of the widely accessible IPCC 2006 method, both nationally and internationally. So it is designed simply, easily, accurately, concisely, and transparently. That's why it is called SMART. And through this online system, the relevant agencies such as ministry, local government, and non-governments can submit their data, their activity data, and emission factor to the Science Sector Directorate General for Climate Change, Ministry of Environment and Forestry. This is an online system where the relevant stakeholders can submit their activity data to the system, and the system will help them to calculate how many are their emission, what emits the emission the biggest emission sector in the city or in the province, and this data will be delivered to the national government. And through the dialogue, we found some concerns. The first one is the local government still face difficulty to access data from the private sector, especially data on fossil fuel and electricity from the state-owned company. And there is a need for the resources, more resources to conduct survey or field inspection to check the accuracy data that is being reported. And city government agency as the focal point for GHG inventory has limited authority to reach out to the other government agencies to request data from them. That's why they need assistance from the planning agencies to coordinate with the other agencies for this data, and more capacity building needed on in terms of data collection, data analysis, and so on. Sorry. In terms of climate action plan, the government of Indonesia has developed a national action plan to reduce greenhouse gas emission called RANGERKA. The provincial governments, as the coordinator of climate change in local level, required to develop their own action plan for the implementation of various activities that directly and indirectly reduce GHG emission. The local climate action plan in each province is formalized through government regulation and should be integrated in the local development planning to allow funding allocation for the actions identified. In developing this local action plan or RANGERKA, provinces have to conduct public consultation that involves actors from the local government unit of the province and of the city and regency, university, non-governmental organization, professional association, and business or private sectors. The focal point of RANGERKA is different from the focal point of the GHG inventory, where the focal point for the GHG inventory is the Ministry of Environment and Forestry, And the focal point of RAD DRK is the local development planning, and the focal point of the National Action Plan on Climate Change is the Ministry of National Developmental Planning. And this slide is about measurement, reporting, and verification, or MRV. So Indonesia has developed its MRV system to track the national GHG emission levels, funding, and impact of mitigation actions that has been implemented. The system aims to assess whether a defined emission reduction target can be achieved and which additional measures are needed. There are three kinds of MRV system in Indonesia. The first one is MRV of mitigation action, which is to determine the level and status of GHG emission before and after mitigation actions, and to monitor the achievement of mitigation actions. The second one is MRV of adaptation. The M of the MRV of adaptation is to monitor the suitability of adaptation action options with level of vulnerability and the achievement of objectives by comparing the indicators in planning with the result of implementation. The last one is MRV of resource for climate change mitigation and adaptation action, which cover the monitoring of funding, which source from local, national, or international, capacity building, technology transfer, and expert procurement. So this displays the MRV scheme set by the presidential decree. As you can see in front of you, the party responsible for the mitigation action, as number one, can submit a report on the planning, implementation, and achievement of mitigation actions to the Ministry of Environment and Forestry for validation. Number two, if the validation result is declared complete, the DGCC or Climate Change Directorate General will commission the MRV team to verify the reported action. In conducting verification, the Climate Change Directorate General will involve experts, and the MRV team will issue an evaluation result. The result will then be assessed by them for approval. If it's approved, this climate change action will be sent to the minister, and the Climate Change Directorate General will recommend the issuance of certification and registration of climate change action. If the report is not approved, it will be returned to the party responsible for revision.